Welcome to this introduction to the Luminos app. This video will demonstrate Luminos on an iPad, but these features work equally well on an iPhone. The main area of Luminos is known as the sky view. You can drag your finger to move the sky view for precision, or aim your device upwards to start motion tracking in the sky. Tapping on the screen at any time will stop motion tracking. The main controls for Luminos are in the toolbar at the bottom of the screen. The browser is the main control for configuring, searching, and selecting in Luminos. From the browser menu, you can access everything in the app, and we will examine it in detail in other tutorial videos. Settings, the user's guide, and support are also located here. Motion tracking can also be activated from the browser. One special control here is used to set location. If you have allowed Luminos to detect your location the first time you started the app, it will set your position automatically using information from your device. Otherwise, you can manually choose a location from the included world database, or set specific longitude, latitude, and elevation coordinates. This selected location is known as your home. If you find yourself away from your home at any time, such as when you are visiting another planet, a button will always be present that will return you there. The center area of the toolbar will show important information such as your location and time when they change. For advanced users, a setting for on-screen display of coordinates can be enabled to allow tracking of the current direction. The coordinate systems can be changed, and specific coordinate locations can be chosen using the dial control. The center toolbar will also show actions and information about your current selection. Objects in the sky view can be selected by single tapping them, and the selection bar will update accordingly. Notice the movement of the selection as new items are tapped. To move through the history of selected items, simply swipe left and right across the current selection. Or to clear the selection, just swipe down. Details about the various action buttons for the current selection are covered in other video tutorials. Now we'll look at the other toolbar controls. Luminos lets you change the flow of time to see how it affects the world around you. Tap the Time button to access those controls. For quick time changes, you can drag the wheel on the edge of the screen up or down to rapidly adjust time, direction, and rate. Or, you can use the buttons at the center of the display to adjust the direction and rate of time. To set a specific time, tap the chevron for access to a full time picker dial. Move the dials to your preferred time, and tap the chevron again to hide this control. Tap the clock icon again to leave the time controls completely. Note that the rate of time remains unchanged when you do this. To quickly return to the actual time on your device, you can always tap the Now button at the top of the screen. The calendar control will give you an idea of what's up in the sky for any particular evening at your home location. Tap any individual category to see which objects will be overhead for this evening. In many categories, you can sort by time of visibility or by magnitude or brightness. Use the slider to easily change the Luminos clock to a specific moment for that evening. In the main calendar display, you can also change the dates of the calculations by tapping the date indicator. This allows you to see the moon phases at a glance. Or, for example, you can discover what objects will be visible this upcoming weekend. The observation button is used to configure remote telescope control or to fine-tune the display to simulate viewing equipment. It is covered in detail in other videos. To change your field of view or zoom level, pinch the screen on your device. While zooming, you can tap a value in the control at top to jump to a specific zoom level. As always, tap Home to restore your view. If you need to temporarily change your elevation, you can do this by dragging three fingers down the screen. To move beyond the basics, check out our full series of videos for more tips on your favorite topics. Then, Get out there and start exploring.